Hey guys, this is Daryl Y Sound, and I'm super excited to showcase to you guys my second and last expansion for Kontakt Gospel Sound Pack, WS01 Piano and Synth. So with this expansion, I feel like it sort of wraps up the vision I had for Kontakt Gospel Sound Pack in terms of its sounds, its features, and let's hop right into it. So this is a tone category, how you access the expansion sound. So before it was, you got all the different tone categories here, and it stopped at special, but now it stops at WS01. So let's go through some of the sounds here. So we have a C3 grand here, a very beautiful C3 grand. It's very woody sound. We have a concert grand here, which is a very beautiful sound. School upright, I named it school upright because it immediately reminded me of uprights you would find sort of out of tune, maybe you find in a music class at your local high school. A whirly, I've really gotten to love whirlies over time as I've developed sounds. Whisperer pad was actually a request from a few customers, so this sort of completes, I guess you can say, most of the synth pad and sort of moving sounds that Kontakt Gospel Sound Pack has. Angelic choir is another choir I wanted to add. I wanted to, with only having, let's see, what was it, two choirs? I think I'm not real big on choirs. We had angels and PCM choir, but I wanted to add this one just to sort of add one more choir sound to give you a little more variety. I'm not too big on choirs. I feel like they just sit in the mix and no one's, using a choir as a mains. But it's nice to have options. These two sounds are requesting me to add. These are some very nice tremolo style. I wouldn't say tremolo, but heavy vibrato string sounds. And then we have releases here. I really like having releases because it adds realism to the sound. And speaking of realism to the sound, so our mod slash velocity menu also has another feature exclusive to this expansion. So I went ahead and I found a technique to sort of mimic something that is missing when most pianos are sampled or included, especially in Kontakt. And that, believe it or not, is the string resonance. So as you can see here, I have dedicated buttons that activate the string resonance for most if not all of our pianos in Kontakt Gospel Sound Pack in this expansion in particular. And what string resonance is, so if you have any montage MODX or any motif older than the XS, I believe they had a string resonance on most of those pianos. And I'll just go ahead and show you instead of trying to describe it to you, but it's built in all or most of the pianos that support it. So I'll do the Austrian grand for example. So I play a little bit of that here. And one thing you're going to notice at the gate here is it's sort of an additive reverb. What it really is, string resonance is when you hold down the sustain pedal, the dampers release, and it's the sound of the strings physically resonating throughout the body of your piano, which in a basic sense almost sort of adds a mini reverb to the sound, really. But you hear this in a lot of pianos, you hear on keyboards. And I wanted to add this because it adds pretty much the full experience, like you're playing this on an actual synthesizer. So that's what it would sound like regularly. And then I'm going to push down the pedal here and then play a note. So in case you just can't hear that, let me turn off the actual piano, and now you hear the string resonance by itself. So hopefully you heard that, and let me turn the piano back on here. And it's beautiful. Now, we had this set up just like how it would be on a keyboard or in real life. This does not play all the time. It specifically only activates when you push the sustain pedal. So. So as you can hear, we don't have it as I'm playing that sustain pedal. Then it activates when I hit the sustain pedal. So that's what this expansion adds, WS01. And let's just go through some of the new sounds and some of the new presets, because what I always try to do is, because this is a new instrument, sometimes you want to have the expansion or whatever you purchased in terms of an add-on or expansion or update as what you use primarily. So you don't want to switch, keep going back and forth between like Kontakt Gospel Soundpad version 3.5 versus this expansion. So, you know, I keep that in mind. So I always try to make sure I have a minimum of at least 100 presets with whatever I release. That way you're not having to go back to different instruments. Well, this instrument had a preset I liked and this new one doesn't. So, you know, that's inevitably going to happen, because I try to make up new presets and also try to improve on other presets. And an improvement to me might not necessarily be an improvement to the person playing, but I still try to have that variety. And I also still try to have that similarity. So we still have 100 presets with this expansion, but we also have some new ones as well. Of course, it says bringing back some old ones. So let's play through some of the new sounds first, and then we'll play through some of the newer presets that are just new combinations of already existing Kontakt Gospel Sound Pack sounds. So this here is the C3 Grand. And let's see here. Oh, I see what happened here. So, looks like my volume got messed up. So I apologize for that. Okay, here we go. Yeah, it's beautiful, beautiful piano. I don't want to get caught up playing here, so let's move on. Let's see. Concert Grand. Very beautiful piano as well. We also have release samples with this. I'll go ahead and solo that real quick. So I've learned, especially with the release samples, as I've been working with them lately, not to have them too loud. So they're there, and you get the realism in the higher velocities. It's still there as well in the lower velocities, but not as much, not to be annoying, especially when you're layering a bunch of chords. So here's the Concert Grand. Thank you. So get my playing here. Not so much a player anymore as I am just a sample developer and scripter. So let's move on to, so we have a different variations of the Whirly here. And what I've done with this expansion is I already have a lot of effects. We have, of course, our global effects, we call master effects down here on all four parts. And then we also have our four part effects section here. But there's some, you know, effects that are just for one sound that I don't justify adding to the script and making a whole new slot. So there's some presets here that are snapshot or rather preset specific to where it's just for that, these effects are just applied in that preset, and these tremolo sounds are one of them. So this is a favorite of mine, this amped tremolo, Whirly tremolo. So that's a fun one. And let's go to the clean Whirly just to show you what that sounds like without any additional effects. And one thing I noticed about this too is that really had the release samples tweaked. It's really fun to play. I love the response it gives those release samples. It makes it feel like you're playing the real instrument. That's real fun. So let's go over to, we'll do the warm one real quick and then we'll move on here. This is another fun one. This is just a, actually it's a amp simulator, or rather amp impulse response ran through our convolution reverb impulse response here. So it's, this is amp warmth, and it does what it says, it warms up the sound. That's a very fun sound. So let's move on here. Let's see what else we got. School upright. So this is another favorite of mine. Y'all know I'm real big on uprights. Thank you. I got caught up playing those sounds. I'll show you a real quick variation of this sound called School Upright Gospel. So this is actually just a combination of different sounds to give it more of a detuned sound, but also a little brighter sound at the same time. So believe it or not, we had the XP80 piano and then the C3 grand, and it's sort of... I'm not real good at ragtime, but I'm sure you can get some nice ragtime out of that. So just a little fun sound. So moving on here. Whisperer is one of those sounds we had. It's in our strings and pads. And it's a very simple sound, but this one was special because I guess there's variations of this sound if you load it into like a Montage Numero DX versus the original ES keyboard or rack. So I went back to the actual source, the ES, and so here it is as presented on the ES. I'm not real big on moving involving pads, but some people are. They like to layer it behind a piano or whatnot, give a certain atmosphere. So that works. So next up here is our two orchestral string sounds, and let's just get right into it. You put some heavy reverb on that, and that's your atmosphere setter right here. Now, this is similar to orchestral string one, but I feel like it's a little bit more clearer. That's something I used to do on Ensemble Mix. What did I used to do on there? I think it was something like a... Of course, I'd probably have to adjust the release to get a better response. Well, you get the idea. Beautiful, beautiful sound. So let's see what else do we get. Everything in here. Oh, the angelic choir. So let's go to strings and pads. Beautiful choir here. And then we have a wonderful variation here. I think it's also in here as well. Heavenly choir. Okay. Ooh. Ooh, that reverb is nasty. Atmosphere setter for sure. So let's see here. So if you'd like to hear most of what Kontakt Gospel Sound Pack comes with, watch our overview video for Kontakt Gospel Sound Pack version 3.5. And that'll show you most of the sounds. I don't want to take up too much time on this video showing sounds we've already showcased. So let's go to some of the newer patches here. This one's just a mix. It's just new, but it's a mix of the synth brass we already have in here. Let's see. I haven't played aux in a while. So this is a little cool brass sound put together already for you there. Let's see what else we have here. So I've revamped for this expansion the MKS-20 section. So I wanted to show you exactly what you're choosing from, exactly what you're playing, because oftentimes I see people skip over patches that they might like over just the default regular MKS-20 patches. So what this includes is, without going into the submenus here, I have a layer here that's very quick, that's very easy to click and get started. It's called two module stack, and what it is, it's just piano 1 and EP2. So that's a very easy and common layer. And then we just have the basic sounds without going into the submenus. So EP2 dry. Okay. And then, of course, piano 1, 2, and 3. And then we can get into the submenus. Factory module, simply, it's just piano 1, 2, and 3 with the original release applied. Exactly how it would release on the actual MKS-20 module. Instead of what you usually hear, where it's just very quick, how I have it for most of the standard patches. You see how quicker that is. So, Live Chorus takes our EP2 dry sound and applies our global MKS-20 chorus, which you can find on part 3 here in the Master Effects section. Again, this is an effect. I turn it off, you get that regular dry sound. Turn it back on. And what's lovely about it too is that for those who only like chorus, turn down the mix. Or you can turn it up to your heart's content. So yeah, that's adjustable. And then sample chorus, it's just our long-standing EP1, EP2 with sample chorus. There's no chorus effect applied. The samples are, or the chorus is baked into the samples. And the detune version of those simply apply our global analog pitch drift you see right here. You can already hear it, you know, going in and out of pitch. I've been playing this key a long time. But alright, let's move on to the gospel stacks and then the splits. So I made this one fairly simple. I don't like gimmicky patches. there's sometimes you have to, well, most of the time, if we're actually going to be honest, you're loading up these libraries and you're not winning gimmicks. You know, gimmicks are nice for sessions or toying around, but there's sometimes you're like, listen, I got it back to Preacher. I need something. And you don't need a gimmicky one with reverb and all these splits and click tracks. I mean, they're nice, but sometimes I just want something that's just gonna, you know. You know what I'm saying? So forget the volume spike there. But yeah, you know, you just want something that's just gonna do it for you right then and there. So I'm not real big on adding a bunch of presets that are just gimmicky, just stuff you can just go to and either get inspired or something you just need immediately for your service. So it's there. These back to Preacher layers here are just different pianos and different combinations. Let's see, Motifia stack. These actually are new from the previous versions here. So what I try to do with these stacks is try to imagine I have an ES and I'm limited to the ES. So this combination is full grand, Yama's EP without the string, background strings, and that's it. So that's a common ES layer. That's what you have on the ES. You don't have all this J-pop brass and MKS and everything else built in. So that's a common ES layer, and then let me go to the next one here. This one's just for shouting. So you would commonly hear in those older YouTube videos, like with gospel players, full gram, EP2, Hugo Saw, and like Profi, like here. So that's a fun one. Let's see what else we got here. Hillsong Worship was a new one I did. We had it before, but I just tweaked it. That sound chain is made through the mod wheel. Moving the mod wheel up and down. That's a pretty one. So, and then we have, I pulled some notes from our Motif Gospel sound pack. And for the splits, I just added one simple one already made up here, which is the MKS 20 shot. So that's a fun one. This is our amp bass. And then we have templates here. And what that is on part 4, amp bass. Let's see. Ain't good at running bass in B flat. But yeah, you can see our key range here. It's C2 to E2. And yeah, about three octaves there. And what the templates do is allow you to start making up your own layers. You have the bass split, and these other three parts are also already splitted with our key range here. So you can just go from there and, you know, add on another piano. So I'm not real good with playing it anymore now that I've gotten into development, but you get the gist here. So we have an amp-based template and a finger-based, for those who like finger-based. So that's the majority of this expansion, ladies and gentlemen. We just got these sounds here. I feel like that sort of completes Kontakt Gospel Sound Pack, and you have a breadth of sounds, which the majority of them, like I said, are showcased on our original video for Kontakt Gospel Sound Pack version 3.5. And we hope you enjoy this expansion. And yeah, thank you so much for supporting Y Sound and Kontakt Gospel Sound Pack.